happy songs, as always, come in. Actually, there's like two at the end to finish off the set, so you'll be fine. Because I'm going to sing a song now called Death Rock Me to Sleep. So, yeah, sorry. It's actually a poem, widely believed to have been written by Anne Boleyn while she was waiting in the tower to be executed. So yes, extremely happy song. I like to think of it as a decent Meatloaf album title though. If I say it in this voice for you, you ready? Death, rock me to sleep. You can see it, can't you? Yeah. If you imagine fireworks coming from the front, flamethrowers, Harley Davidson's flying from behind me, Ed, it'll make the song a lot more interesting for you, I assure you. Just checking in, Sheen. See, you'll be all distracted now. I'll be singing this plaintive song, poignant and plaintive, and you'll just be imagining motorbikes. I've ruined it for you, really. Sorted. So this is Death, Rock Me to Sleep. That's never happened to me at any festival before this weekend, ladies and gentlemen, is I've been given gifts. Was anybody at my concert last night in the Sabrina? I don't know, I see. Well, those people will know I got given Battenberg. Everyone else, I got given Battenberg before a gig. It was amazing. It's my favourite cake as well. And then this morning, when I was walking to my sound check, a really lovely young couple that I met at a folk club in Birmingham, we'd have this discussion about, wouldn't it be good if you had like a mascot biscuit? You know, a biscuit that starts with the same letter as your name. So for example, Helen Hobnob or Catherine Custard Cream. But there aren't any biscuits that begin with L. But she found these, they're called Luscious Lemon Curds. So I'm Luscious Lemon Curd Lucy. So I just like it noted that biscuits and cakes are welcome at every gig, every festival if I see you again. Right, I wasn't planning on singing this song today, but my hero, June Tabor, is playing with the Oyster Band later. And she was backstage when I was there having a croissant this morning. And I couldn't even talk to her, I was so starstruck. I had an album in my bag and I wanted to give it to her, but I was too scared. I'm hoping that by this afternoon, I'll pluck up the courage. I might go to the bar to help me with that situation. But yeah, she really got me into folk music, really, listening to her records. So I'm going to sing a song that I learnt from the singing of her, but it's about Derby, which, as I've told you, is where I'm from. So, you know, it's about Derby. It mentions a pigeon. You can tell it's a song of lyrical genius. It's called The King of Rome, and it's written by a fella called Dave Sudbury.
In the West End of Derby, there lives a working man. He says I can't fly, but me pigeons can. And when I set them free, it's just like a part of me gets lifted up on shining wings. Charlie Hudson's pigeon loft was down the yard of a rented house in Brook Street where life was hard. But Charlie had a dream, and in 1913 Charlie bred a pigeon to make his dreams come true. There was going to be a champions race from Italy. We got out the maps, all that land and sea. Charlie will lose that bird, but Charlie never heard. He put it in a basket and sent it off to Rome. On the day of the big race, a storm blew in. 1,000 birds were swept away and never seen again. Charlie, we told you so. Surely by now you know. When you're living in the West End, there ain't many dreams come true. Yeah, I know, but I have to try. A man can crawl, or he can learn to fly. And if you live round here, the crown seems awful near. Sometimes I need a lift from victory. I went out with me mates for a pint or two, when I saw a wing flash up in the blue. Charlie, it's the King of Rome, come back to his West End home. Come outside quick, he's perched upon your roof. Come on down, Your Majesty. I knew you'd make it back to me. Come on down, my lovely one. You've made my dreams come true. Now in the West End of Derby, there lives a working man. He says I can't fly, but me pigeons can. And when I set them free, it's just like a part of me gets lifted up on shining.